Welcome to Riverview Kids in Action, a Bible-based Christian community that is family-oriented and Christ-centered. Join us for praise and worship in music, Bible story time, arts and crafts. Come, meet Cooper and friends and learn practical lessons for life. Join us for creation expeditions and learn more about God's second book, nature. Welcome to Riverview Kids in Action.
Glad you joined us today. I'm so glad that we are all safe at our houses, and I hope that you are all safe. Let's have prayer to talk about that. Dear God, thank you that you are so good to us and that you always loved us. Thank you that you love us from the time that you made Adam and Eve till now. I hope that we go through this hard time very easily, and that none of our church members die of this. I also pray for the doctors and nurses as they are going through this. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. And our first line would be, Sabbath is a happy day. Sabbath is a happy day, isn't it?
Thank you. deep, deep. So let's go deep, 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 deep. Touch the ground. That's the most deepest love you have.
Yeah.
good.
Hello, boys and girls. It's time for our story today. And first, we're going to do our memory verse. And our memory verse is from Acts 10:34. God does not show favoritism. Do you know what favoritism is? Favoritism is when you give someone more benefits than someone else, when you don't treat everyone equally. God wants us to treat everyone equally, so he wants you to treat your best friend the same way you meet a stranger, or the same way you treat as someone you just met, or maybe someone that you don't like as much. He wants you to treat everyone the same, with kindness and with love and respect. Now, our story today is about people working in a vineyard, and it's actually a story that Jesus told. Now, a vineyard is a place that you grow grapes. So I don't grow grapes in my yard, but I grow blueberries and I grow flowers and I grow tomatoes. So when I go work in my yard, these are my gardening gloves. And as you can see, they're kind of dirty because when I'm working in my garden, I'm working in the dirt and it's hard work and your hands get all dirty and you might get sweaty and it's a lot of work to work in your garden. And here I have my little hand tools. I have my little rake I'll use for loosening up the soil so I can get in there and get the weeds out. And this is something you might use in a vineyard. These are my clippers, and they're really sharp pruning shears for clipping off dead branches or branches on trees or on roses that I want to grow a different direction or not be so thick. So these are some of the things I use when I work in the garden. Now, yesterday I worked out in the yard because it was pretty nice, and I worked outside for about 2.5 hours, and then I was like, whoo, I'm hot, I need a drink of water, I need to maybe make my lunch. But in our story today, some people are gonna work all day long, and I want you to see what happens and how they're treated. So this story is called Payday at the Vineyard. In Jesus's time, men would gather in the marketplace at 6 a.m. There, they would wait for someone to come and hire them. One morning, a vineyard owner came looking for workers. At 6 a.m., he hired some men. He agreed to pay them the usual pay for 12 hours of work. At 9, he came back to the marketplace. He saw men still standing around. "Go work in my vineyard and I'll pay you what is right," he told them. At 12:00 and at 3:00, he hired more men. Again at 5 p.m, just 1 hour before quitting time, he did the same thing. At 6 p.m, the landowner told his foreman to pay the workers. He should begin with those who were hired last and end with those who were hired first. First, the foreman paid those who had worked only 1 hour. He gave them a full day's pay. Then he paid those who had worked for 3 hours. He gave them a full day's pay too. those who were hired first, he began to smile. They were sure they would receive more. After all, they had worked longer and harder than the others. It would only be fair, wouldn't it? But when they received their pay, their smiles turned to frowns. They got the same pay as everyone else. Wait, they complained. Those men worked only 1 hour. You made them equal to us. We did most of the work, and in the heat of the day, too. I'm not being unfair to you, said the landowner. You agreed to work for the usual pay for a day's work. That's what I'm paying you. I can do what I want with my money. Don't be jealous, because I am generous. And then Jesus said it again. The last will be first, and the first will be last. Do you think it's fair? You may not. And that's the point Jesus was making. God does not treat us the way we deserve. God treats us much, much better. It is His grace that saves all of us, those who accept Him at the last minute and those who accept Him early. God doesn't have to save any of us. He does it because He loves us. Do you treat others in God's family the same way God has treated you? When someone is mean to you, do you treat them with love and kindness? Try to treat others as God treats us. And I hope that you guys have a great day. Let's have a quick prayer before we go into our next activity. Dear Jesus, thank you so much for loving us the way that you do. Please be with us this week as we interact with our moms and our dads and our families and other people around us. And please help us to treat everyone with kindness and love, no matter what, the way God would want us to. In your name we pray. Amen. Bye.
Hey, Cooper. It's so good to see you again. I've been really concerned about you. How have you been?
Hey, Cole. I'm feeling splendidivory. Whee!
Oh, that sounds interesting. What do you mean?
I'm feeling good. Really, 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 really good.
I'm happy to hear that. Your mom has been really worried about you, such as you have a nasty flu.
I was feeling very froggy.
Froggy?
Yeah, you know, tired, exhausted. I didn't know the flu could be so horrible. My whole body hurt all over. My head hurt, my back hurt, my stomach hurt, my neck hurt, my legs hurt, my arms hurt, and my tail hurt. I just couldn't get comfortable in my bed, and my throat felt like somebody had rubbed sandpaper all over it. And my mom gave me ice cream to try to help, and it
what
just...
kind of...
Well, I was sick all over my bed, and I was coughing and feeling cold, and I kept asking for extra blankets, and...
That's probably...
Mom said that I had a very high temperature, and...
She told me that.
I didn't understand why I could feel with such a high temp... I felt cold with such a high temperature, and Mom kept putting cold flannels on my forehead, which I didn't like. They felt awful, and then... All this, oh my goodness, I just was so sick.
Donkeys are red?
Huh? Are you alright?
I was trying to join in with this conversation, Cooper.
Oh.
I was listening to you really hard, James, but I would like to say some things too.
Sorry, I was getting a bit carried away, wasn't I?
You were, but I'm glad that you are feeling less froggy now. I have been praying for you a lot.
You have?
I have indeed. In fact, your Heavenly Father kept on reminding me to pray for you.
So, Father God spoke to you about me?
Yes, Cooper. He did. Many times over the past couple weeks.
No way! What did he say?
Oh, phew. As long as he didn't say anything, it was about Difa.
Huh? Yeah, Difa the dog. But there's something I don't understand. You said that God spoke to you. I thought that we did all the speaking to Father God. You know, we prayed to Him.
When we pray, Cooper, we have a conversation with Father God, a bit like you and I have just had. Sometimes we do the speaking, and sometimes Father God does the speaking. And we need to listen to Him. when he does.
I don't find listening really easy, clearly.
I know that.
But, Father God says things like, donkeys are red?
Not exactly, but it is hard to build up a relationship with him if we've never listened to him.
I don't think Father God has ever spoken to me. I've never heard his great loud voice booming into my ear.
Well, actually, when Father God speaks to you, his voice is very often as quiet as a whisper, gently speaking into your thoughts.
So, how do I know that it's Father God speaking, not me thinking my own thoughts?
That's a good question. We got to recognize Father God's voice by getting to know him through reading our Bibles. We can also share with what we think that we have heard with someone who has been a Christian for a while.
Like you?
Yes, Cooper, like me.
Thanks. Can we have a go now at listening?
Of course. Shut your eyes and be very quiet. Father God, please speak to James today by your Spirit. Cooper, just wait and see what comes into your mind.
I think that Father God has something for me.
Great. Would you like to share it?
I think he says that I need to tell you about Difa.
Go on.
The thing is, I let Difa out of his cage, and I just found one of my dad's brand new slippers completely chewed up, and I don't know what to do. Can you help me?
Oh, Cooper.
Good morning, children. For our craft this morning, we're going to make heart-shaped coupons. And then you can pull it out like this. And the coupon says, because I want to treat you as God, this coupon entitles you to ask me to do the following for you when you have other things you need or want to do. And then you give it to that person, either it's your mom or dad or grandparents, and they'll write in what they want you to do, and they're gonna sign and date it, okay? So for today's craft, you will need colored pieces of paper, like this, or just simple white, which Evan has already written on. Markers or crayons, a glue stick or tape, and some scissors, all right? So the first thing you'll want to do is you want to take your colored piece of paper, like this, and we're going to fold it. We're going to make the heart first, okay? Fold it hamburger style. And then either you can draw a half a heart or you can cut right away. Oops, that doesn't work. Two halves hearts, and either we're going to glue them in the middle like this, or you can tape them, or you can use whatever you have at home, okay? So,
then a date line as well.
Okay, so it's gonna look like this. All right, and the next thing we need to do is we need to close our cards so that they'll be able to open it. So we'll need to take it in like this. And then we're just gonna fold it in the middle. Give it to them and then they'll be able to put it on their fridge, use it whenever they want. Be able to pull it. Look at that. That's the cool part. And the next thing they need to do is now is to, the fun part is to decorate. So I'm going to color in my heart. I'm going to put flowers right here. Flowers, you can do whatever you want. Do a stem of flowers. And on the other side, I'm just going to make some other hearts with different color. For other flowers. This, pull it in, yeah, and then I'm gonna give this, you know what, I'm gonna put a little piece of tape here so it doesn't open up when I give it to my parents or to whomever I'm gonna give it to. Right, so to close out, let's pray. And let's ask God to help us to treat others that He would treat and not how we think they should be treated. Dear Jesus, thank you for this Sabbath day. Thank you for Sabbath school, for to be able to sing and learn a story and be able to create something out of nothing. And today I just ask a special blessing over all of the kids, all of the children from Riverview, and also help us be able to treat others the way you would treat us and not the way we think we should treat them. Thank you for your love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Have a good day. Bye.